APA swift-moving hurricane Nate rolled toward a midnight landing Saturday along the Gulf Coast as a Category 1 hurricane, sending residents from southeast Louisiana to Florida scrambling to prepare for high winds and life-threatening storm surge. New Orleans authorities said the city's pumping system is fragile but working. New Orleans and Lake Pontchartrain were both under a hurricane warning. As of 8 a.m. ET, the National Hurricane Center said Nate was 245 miles south-southeast of the mouth of the Mississippi River, moving north-northwest at a 22-mile-per-hour clip, bearing maximum sustained winds of 85 miles per hour. More: how did Nate pop up so quickly? Expert explains more. Yes, this hurricane season has been much worse than usual. Nate's fast pace is expected to continue all day, with the center of the storm making landfall along the central Gulf Coast late Saturday. Some additional strengthening is possible before Nate makes landfall along the northern Gulf Coast, the Hurricane Center said. Hurricane force winds extended outwards for up to 35 miles from the center, and could increase in speed from 80 miles per hour as Nate moves across the Gulf. The forecast warns of a storm surge up to 9 feet in some areas from the mouth of the Mississippi to the Alabama-Florida border. A storm surge warning was in effect from Morgan City, Louisiana, to the Okaloosa-Walton County line in Florida. Also included were the northern and western shores of Lake Pontchartrain. Louisiana Governor John Bel Edwards urged residents to take Nate seriously, saying the storm has the potential to do a lot of damage. No one should take this storm lightly. It has already claimed the lives of at least 20 people, Edwards said. We do want people to be very, very cautious, and to not take this storm for granted. States of emergency were declared in Louisiana, Mississippi and Alabama as Nate, which has already killed at least 21 people in Central America, became the latest in a succession of destructive storms this hurricane season. Edwards said. Forecasts indicate the greatest risks are winds and storm surge, rather than intense amounts of rain. That's good news for New Orleans, where the city's pumping system remains fragile. Two flash floods this summer led to revelations about personnel and equipment problems at the agency that runs the system that drains the city. New Orleans Mayor Mitch Landrieu said 109 of its 120 pumps are functioning, a 92% capacity. We are ready for whatever Nate brings our way, Landrieu said. Mississippi Governor Phil Bryan declared a state of emergency in 6 southernmost counties. State officials, at a briefing Friday in Gulfport, warned that Nate's main danger will be the up to 10 feet of storm surge in low-lying coastal areas, as well as from winds that could damage mobile homes. If you are in an area that has flooded, I would recommend you evacuate that area until the storm has ended and the water has receded for your own personal safety, and for the safety of the first responders that will be responding in the event you are trapped, Bryant said. Contributing, Associated Press.